Today's video is all about one special type of flying machine – incremental engines. Incremental flying machine is a type of flying machine with incomplete cycle. It moves set amount of blocks upon some sort of external input. Incremental engines are a must-have in places where you want to make sure you have full control of the machine. It may be in testing phase, where you don't want your machine to run forward and fully brake. A step of one block will help you test that everything works well. Same goes for machines like tunnel bores, where you want to make sure you removed all liquids and obsidian before moving forwards. It is also used as components in some bigger machinery, like return stations and quarries. There exists three types of incremental flying machines: semi-automatic flying machine, manual update flying machine, and manual activation flying machine. Semi-automatic flying machine is a type of incremental flying machine that requires no external power source or items in player's hand to be activated. This is the most comfortable type of incremental engines to use. You don't need to have anything on you, just toggle fence gate or trapdoor. Only one thing to keep in mind, they can set on fire from nearby lava. This can be fixed in 1.13 by using node blocks instead. By the way, all of the engines that I will be showing today were designed in 1.12.2 with old versions in mind, but they should work well in newer versions too. However, with node blocks and Honey, some of them can probably be compacted even more. You can download the world from the description and try improving the engines yourself. Sadly, there is no easy option of detecting state changes in versions before observers were added. In versions prior to 1.11, your best option is next type of incremental engine. Manual update flying machine is a type of incremental flying machine that requires block update, like with flint and steel, fire charge hands, etc., to be activated. This is already not as comfortable, since you need to have some items on you to create block update for the budded engine to move. Best ways to create block updates is to use flint and steel, fire charge, or place blocks that are breakable by the pistons, like string or melon blocks. Sadly, it's not always possible or easy to butt some piston on a flying machine. Thus, third type of incremental machines exist. Manual activation flying machine is a type of incremental flying machine that requires external redstone power source to be activated. Best example of manual activation engines are piston worms. They are the first type of flying machine to exist and still widely used today in many fields of Minecraft. Let's finally take a look at different incremental engines. Let's start with one-way horizontal engines. Obviously, oldest one is just piston worm. It's a manual activation engine, meaning that you need redstone to trigger it. And they can be made both ways or vertical. I will not be covering them from now on. So let's continue with more interesting stuff. In Minecraft 1.5, redstone blocks were added, and that made the flying machine possible. So here is modified version of Myron's engine. So I bought this piston, and by updating it you will trigger the flying machine. Once again, you can update it with flint and steel or fire charge, it doesn't matter. And I placed a gold block so you can easily see where to place your fire. So yeah, now this piston is butted once again, and you can trigger it the next time. It's pump proof, by the way, it will not break. So best we can do in our engines is manual update engines. That doesn't necessarily mean that we always need some items on us to activate them. There are weird ways of doing that. Redstone ore comes quite close, but it will trigger machine again upon deactivation on random tick. Here I turned Myron's engine into an active flying machine that will move on random ticks. Other way is using block breaking to trigger flying machine. For that you need to somehow regenerate blocks on the flying machine. It can be piston heads, mushrooms or vines. Obviously it will be bulky and slow. This is cool, but that's not always very useful, because with Cobra technologies you're often working hundreds of blocks away from the engine itself. So a good solution for that is a manual activation engine. This was made by MXI. He modified slightly Myron's engine to trigger this piston. So yeah, you can be hundreds of blocks away and just press any button and it will move the machine forwards one block. And obviously he is using melon blocks, because they will be automatically broken by the flying machine, and no floating stuff will be left behind. So let's wait for it to break a melon block. Yep. Next we have manual update engine for 1.8 and above. All 1.8 engines are basically different variations of Caterpillar engine. So it's nothing special. And as for 1.11 and above, we have this design by Glow Squid. Glow Squid is a genius of compact limestone. I was working one day on those engines, like compacting them on Duct Creative, and he came and just beat me like in almost all 1.11 engines that are one way. So next we have vertical engines. Here is downwards engine for 1.11 semi-automatic incremental engine. Yeah, nice use of gravity blocks. And here is a 1.8 version of that, but manual activation. You may say this is decremental engine, am I right? Yeah, whatever. So now let's look at upwards engine. Here is semi-automatic incremental engine for 1.11 plus, and here is for 1.8 plus manual update engine that will fly up. Now let's look at two-way engines. So here is horizontal two-way semi-automatic engine for 1.11 plus. This is once again by Glow Squid. Very cool design in my opinion. So yeah, as you can see, works. And here can be used for an extension. And here is a 1.8 version. This is made by Senrad, one of the greatest limestoners in my opinion. So here it is, flying one way, and by clicking on this piston we can make it fly other way. Yeah, great stuff. Now let's look at vertical ones. So here is for 1.11. Pretty basic stuff. And here is for 1.8. This is basically Sunrise engine, but slightly modified. So yeah, here it will fly up. And now let's fly it down. Next, let's look at diagonal engines. So here is an engine by El Mango, diagonal semi-automatic incremental engine. And here is 1.8 plus diagonal engine that is actually manual activation. This is a modified version of Pice engine. So yeah, as you can see, you need an external power source for it to work. Sadly, I wasn't able to make it into a manual update engine. So maybe if that's what you wanna try to make, that would be pretty cool. But it's really hard to do in 1.8 with just 12 push limit. I actually succeeded with 14 push limit, but yeah, that's not good. Now let's look at horizontal four-way engine. This one is semi-automatic and will move in all four directions. So yeah, it's once again a modified version of an engine by Capster and Error. But yeah, I just sped it up a bit and changed some stuff. I showed it already in an earlier video on this channel. And here is another engine I already showed. It's same engine basically, but vertical. But this is sadly manual activation. This is because horizontally I have fan speeds, but sadly without quasi connectivity it's really hard to do the vertical powering without exceeding push limit on those segments. So yeah, it needs flint and steel for those two directions. As for 1.8 versions of those engines, I'm pretty sure they're possible. I tried around, but wasn't successful. Once again, I was out of push limit, but I was quite close. I'm like at push limit 20 or something like that. So yeah, that's another thing that maybe you want to work on and provide the world with amazing technologies. Now let's look at some random goofy engines that are that don't really fit in any of those categories. So here we have a two-way horizontal manual update engine, and the reason it's for 1.12 and above is because we use terracotta blocks, but I quite like it. So next one we have one-way horizontal manual update incremental engine that increments by two blocks by Samrat, and this is probably the weirdest engine I ever seen in my entire life. Yeah, I can't even comprehend what it's doing. Really cool one. Next one is by ETA. This is two-way manual update engine for 1.12 and above, once again because of terracotta. This one is really useful in like big machinery. I think I used it before even. Next we have transparent one-way manual update engine. It's not transparent in versions above 1.13, but in versions below it, this is transparent because for power we use minecarts on detector rails. Transparent flying machines aren't really useful, but they may be used when you want to fly a flying machine above a mob farm, like for portal caching. It can also be used to fly above light update detector to become undetectable. So yeah. Next we have two really cool engines by Elmango. This is a diagonal engine that moves 18 degrees, and this is diagonal engine that moves 26 degrees, actually other way around. So it will first move one block forward, and next time it will move forward and diagonally. And this one will move twice forward and now diagonally. Yeah, really cool engines. And at last I wanted to give you an example how to increment by many blocks, not just one or two. So here is an example. So it just incremented by 10 blocks, and you can control amount of distance it will increment with length of this arm. So here's for 10, now it will be 9, 8. You can also make it longer just by adding a simple extension like that, for example. There are quite a few more exotic engines you can make incremental versions of that I didn't cover in this video, like those that move vertically diagonally, or those that move diagonally two ways. So yeah, that's also a project to work on if you're interested in developing such stuff. Thanks for watching and bye!